Welcome to Songs of Praise with Trowbridge Citadel Salvation Army. We're really pleased that you've chosen to join us in worship today. In worship in song and music, prayers and readings, many of which have been chosen by members of our congregation and some of which have been chosen by me as some of my favourites. Well, I'm sure that we're going to be in for a good time as we praise God through music and song, both traditional and modern. And we also pray that you'll be blessed and hopefully challenged too, as we spend this time together watching, listening, and hopefully joining in just where you are. Well, our first song for today has been chosen by Jane Wickham, and she says that this song not only speaks of God's glory, but it also gives him the praise which he so richly deserves, as he has answered so many of our prayers during the last 3 months, and he continues to answer them too. As you sing, you'll see that in the verses of this song, there is talk of God's love and his care, even in the most difficult circumstances of life. And it's fair to say that we have all been in very difficult circumstances over these last 3 months. But as we have brought our prayers before our God, he has listened, he has answered. And for that, we praise the Lord.
Psalm 103, a Psalm of David, and this is taken from the Message paraphrase. O my soul, bless God. From head to toe, I'll bless his holy name. O my soul, bless God. Don't forget a single blessing. He forgives your sins, every one. He heals your diseases, every one. He redeems you from hell, saves your life. He crowns you with love and mercy, a paradise crown. He wraps you in goodness, beauty eternal. He renews your youth. You're always young in his presence. God makes everything come out right. He puts victims back on their feet. He showed Moses how he went about his work, opened up his plans to all Israel. God is sheer mercy and grace, not easily angered. He's rich in love. He doesn't endlessly nag and scold, nor hold grudges forever. He doesn't treat us as our sins deserve, nor pay us back in full for our wrongs. As high as heaven is over the earth, so strong is his love to those who fear him. And as far as sunrise is from sunset, he has separated us from our sins. As parents feel for their children, God feels for those who fear him. He knows us inside and out, keeps in mind that we're made of mud. Men and women don't live very long. Like wild flowers, they spring up and blossom, but a storm snuffs them out just as quickly, leaving nothing to show they were here. God's love, though, is ever and always eternally present to all who fear him, making everything right for them and their children as they follow his covenant ways and remember to do whatever he said. God has set a throne in heaven. He rules over us all. He's the King. So bless God, you angels ready and able to fly at his bidding, quick to hear and do what he says. Bless God, all you army of angels, alert to respond to whatever he wills. Bless God, all creatures, wherever you are, everything and everyone made by God. And you, O my soul, bless God. Amen.
We thank John for choosing and reading that psalm. And he's also chosen our next song, which is based on that psalm and reminds us that we must bless, praise and worship God, not just in the good times, but in the difficult times too, and in the ordinary, mundane circumstances of life also. But of course, maintaining that can be hard. But as our first song and our psalm remind us, he is a God who loves and cares. He loves and cares for each one of us. And there are so many reasons to go on worshipping him. And so we sing 10,000 Reasons by Matt Redman.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the
acknowledge that life has its ups and downs and that we don't always know what's happening or why. And that could very much be said about this pandemic and this time that we have found ourselves in. But we have a God who knows, who cares, who understands, who holds the plan for each one of us and for the whole world. And so we must worship him, trust him, and put ourselves in our rightful place before him. That's to say, we bow the knee and we live by faith, not by sight. Listen and reflect as Marston brings to us this beautiful song, accompanied by his wife Mandy.
There seems to be no reason for the suffering we feel. We are tempted to believe God does not know. When the storms arise, don't forget we live by faith and not by sight. Father, kneel, trust the heart of your Father when the answer goes beyond what you can see. Bow the knee, lift your eyes toward heaven and believe the one who holds eternity. And when you don't understand the purpose of his plan, in the presence of the King, bow the knee. Trust the heart of your Father when the answer goes beyond what you can see. Bow the knee, lift your eyes toward heaven and believe the one who holds eternity. And when you don't understand the purpose of his plan, in the presence of the King, bow the knee.
Dear God, we come before you now as mere human beings, trying to make sense of our world, our lives, and all that is happening to us. There is much we don't understand. There is much to confuse us and make us angry, anxious, and sad. Help us to remember our place, that whatever we are going through, however we are feeling, you are God, and you are in control. Help us to recognise that when we can't see the path ahead, you can. And even if you choose not to reveal that path to us, help us to remember that you travel it with us. You guide us along it and support us when we need it. Help us to look to you, to trust you, to realise that you truly are God, the one who created our world and each one of us, the one who governs and sustains all life, the one who holds the plan for today and for all eternity. And so, Lord, we would say that we love you. We would trust you, and we want and need you in our lives every moment of every day. So help us to praise you and bless you as the God who loves and cares for us. Help us to seek your presence, to rest in that presence, and to rely on you for all we need to face each and every day and each and every situation that will come our way. O Lord, may we learn to bow the knee and live by faith in you alone. Amen.
Yeah.
That song was chosen for us today by Matthew as one of his favourites. He says the words are so supportive and reassuring and have been particularly helpful for him in these last few weeks. Matthew also chose the video version as he felt that the graphics fit the song so well. Knowing the Lord is with us at all times and in all circumstances is a great comfort and reassurance. This knowledge and actually feeling his presence and being able to bring all our cares and concerns to him, relying on him for all we need, that brings his peace to our hearts. Jane is now going to read to us words of St. Paul, which focus on all of this and help us to grasp what it is to know the peace of God.
The reading is taken from Philippians chapter 4, verses 4 to 13, and I'm reading from the NIV. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. I rejoice greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all this through him who gives me strength. Amen.
In the power and the strength of Jesus Christ, Paul learnt to worship God in all circumstances. And he also learnt to be content, whatever the circumstance he faced. And it has to be said that Paul faced some pretty awful ordeals. Shipwrecks, false trials, torture, imprisonment. And yet even in those most dreadful of times, he put his faith in God, he continued to worship him and trust him, and so he knew the peace of God. And that has continued to be the experience of many Christians over many years in many difficult situations. Horatio Spafford suffered several traumatic events in his life. The first two were the death of his four-year-old son, and the Great Chicago Fire of 1871, which ruined him financially. His business interests were further hit by the economic downturn of 1873, at which time he'd planned to travel to Europe with his family on the SS Villeneuve. But in a late change of plan, he sent the family on ahead, while he was delayed on business. While crossing the Atlantic Ocean, the ship sank rapidly after a collision with another sea vessel, and all four of Spafford's daughters died. His wife Anna survived, and she sent the now famous telegram, "Saved alone." Shortly afterwards, as Spafford crossed the Atlantic to meet his grieving wife, he was inspired to write his famous hymn as his ship passed near the place where his daughters died. He turned to God in his darkest hour, and he knew his peace in his heart as he focused on worshipping God for who he knew him to be and for all that he knew he had done for him through Jesus. Spafford was assured of his salvation and his eternal future, and so he continued to make that the focus of his praise and worship, and his reason to bless the Lord, whatever his lot. And so he was able to say, "It is well with my soul." When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to know, it is well with my soul. we're going to listen to a piano solo by Nick King of this famous song. It is very moving, it is very beautiful, and I pray that as you listen, you will know the peace of God, and you will know it is well with your soul.
Thank you.
And so we realise that as we bless the Lord, he continues to bless us, whatever circumstances we face. And we will know that and feel that as long as we remain faithful to him, as long as we live the life he has called us to, and as long as we give him his rightful place in our lives. Jesus put it like this when he talked about the kind of attitudes we should live by and the priorities we should hold.
The Bible reading comes from Matthew 5, verses 3 to 10, and I'm reading from the Message paraphrase. You're blessed when you're at the end of your rope. With less of you, there is more of God and his rule. You're blessed when you feel you've lost what is most dear to you. Only then can you be more embraced by the one most dear to you. You're blessed when you're content with just who you are, no more, no less. That's the moment you find yourselves proud owners of everything that can't be bought. You're blessed when you've worked up a good appetite for God. He's food and drink in the best meal you'll ever eat. You're blessed when you care. At the moment of being careful, you find yourselves cared for. You're blessed when you get your inside world, your mind and heart, put right. Then you can see God in the outside world. You're blessed when you can show people how to cooperate instead of compete or fight. That's when you discover who you really are and your place in God's family. You're blessed when your commitment to God provokes persecution. The persecution drives you even deeper into God's kingdom. Amen.
In the Good News Bible, the word happy is used instead of the word blessed in that reading. We're content, blessed, happy when we know God, when we accept all he has done for us through Jesus, when we live life his way and worship him with every part of our being, in every aspect of our lives, whether in good times or in bad times, just as Paul described in those words he wrote to the Philippians and how he demonstrated that in his life, and also just as Horatio Spafford showed through his life experiences and his testimony as written in song. When we bless God, he blesses us, and we are happy people. Salvationists are apparently known for being happy people, just as this video shows.
Clap along, yeah.
That song was, of course, called Happy. And our next song is a happy song. This is one of my choices for today, and it really is a favourite of mine because as well as being so happy and jolly, it's also a testimony, my testimony, which of course should be a happy thing. This song tells of my experience of Jesus, of how he has saved me and blessed me, and how he makes me happy, such that I want to praise and bless him and make him happy by loving and serving him faithfully. God, through Jesus, makes us happy. And whatever else might be going on around us, even a pandemic, we can be happy because of God's love for us. It's really quite hard to sing this song without smiling, I find. So I do hope you'll be smiling as you sing along. But more than that, I hope you will know the experience of being content and happy, and that you'll know the blessing that comes from God and the happiness that life with Jesus brings. Our bandmaster has chosen a piece of music for us to listen to just now. It's an arrangement of They Shall Come From the East, They Shall Come From the West by Kevin Larson. The lyrics, of course, were written by the late General John Gowans, and they remind us that there is a place for all in God's blessed, happy kingdom. No matter what your background, no matter what you've been through in life, there's a place for everyone in his heavenly, peaceful home. When we trust him, when we worship him, when we have an experience of the loving, saving grace of Jesus. The words of the song bring us comfort, assurance and blessing that all will be well. They shall come from the east, they shall come from the west, and sit down in the kingdom of God. Out of great tribulation to triumph and rest, they'll sit down in the kingdom of God. From every tribe and every race, all men as brothers shall embrace. They shall come from the east, they shall come from the west and sit down in the kingdom of God.
Thank you.
Our final song for this service today has also been chosen by Jane Wickham, and it brings us full circle. We praise and worship God for who he is, for all he has done for us, for all he has planned for us. And as we bless him, he continues to bless us. And we simply want all the glory to go to him.
Give you peace. His face shine upon you.
And be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you.
And give you peace.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Manna rained down from heaven. This isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and the children, and the children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and your children, and your children.